Let's take our next question, that is question number 16. Now the question you see belongs to section of communication system, that is modern physics. Now as per the question, in order to double the covering range of a TV tower, the height should be multiplied by. So you all know as per the formula, the distance covered would be equal to under root 2 into height of the TV tower into the radius. If I want to double this thing, definitely this height can be or should be multiplied with definitely 4. Answer 4, right? Let's move on to our next question, that is question number 17. Now this question belongs to section of mechanics. Here on the inclined plane, a block is kept and it remains at rest up to a maximum force of 2 Newton down the inclined plane. So when only 2 Newton was applied down the inclined plane, it does not move, that's the last limit. Then the maximum external force up the inclined plane, that is 10 Newton when it was applied, so this was not applied in that case, then also it does not move. So we need to find the coefficient of friction here, right? Let's see. In the case when you forget this one, so definitely a weight will be acting downwards and it would be like this, right? And if I resolve this weight, so let's write that first, mg. If this is 30 degree, so with vertical, it will be making an angle of 60 degree like this. So this would be 30 degree, right? Now, there's one force which is acting in this direction and one force which is acting in this direction, that is perpendicular to the incline. This would be mg sin 30, right? And this would be mg cos 30. Now what we want is, we have to calculate. So definitely when we take only this force into account, this is not there, it is trying to go this side, so friction will be upstairs, upwards. Now in this case, let's say it is F1, so I'll write F1 should be equal to mg sin 30, that is by 2 plus 2, right? Now what is the value of F1? That would be simply mu into n. And what is the value of n here? So n will be acting upwards, so n would be equal to mg cos 30. Let's put down the values. So in solution, you have n as equals to mg cos 30, and that would be equal to mg root 3 by 2, right? Now, so F1 would be equal to mu into root 3 by 2 mg. And in this formula here, we can put that root 3 by 2 mu mg should be equal to mg by 2 plus 2. Let's take this as equation 1. Now, let's consider this force of 10 Newton. When this force is acting upwards, and definitely weight will be keep on acting downwards, and this is the maximum force, it tries to pull the block up, so the friction will go down. In that case, there will be a different case. So let's see. In that case, you will say that 10 should be equal to mg sin 30 downwards, and the friction force which is acting downwards will be also added, so mu mg cos 30, right? Solving this, you will get 10 is equals to mg by 2 plus root 3 by 2 mu mg. This is equation 2 for us. So from equation 1 and 2, when you compare, you will find that mu will be equal to root 3 by 2, right? So let's see which is the best suited option here. Among the four options given, option number 2 is the right answer. Right? Let's move ahead and see our next question. Now this question belongs to a section of mechanics. Here, a soap bubble blown by a mechanical pump at the mouth of a tube increases in volume with time. So there was some relation of volume and time at a constant rate. The graph that correctly depicts the time dependence of pressure inside the bubble is given by. So basically we need a relation between pressure and time here so that we can draw the graph. Now you are all well aware that for any bubble, since bubble has two surfaces, you can write P minus P naught, that should be equal to 4S by R. So pressure will be written as 4S by R plus P naught, right? Now volume is equals to 4 by 3 pi R cube. So from here you can write R is equals to 3V by 4 pi power 1 by 3. Also, volume was holding a relation with time. So let's take it as kt. So here R can be written as 3 kt 4 pi power 1 by 3. So when you put this thing here in this equation, you will get P is equals to 4s by 3kT 1 by 3, and this 4 pi will go 1 by 3 plus P naught. So in and all, the relation between this you can see as P is equals to some constant m into 1 by T power 1 by 3 plus an intercept. Now with this relation, so let's see which is the best suited option. So the first one does not satisfy that, second one does not either. When you see this one, this could have been, but it's cube. If this would have been like this, this could have been our option. So among the four, none of the option matches. Hope this will be given to you as a bonus question. Let's move on to our next question.